All right, I'm going to do an extremely quick video about solving equations with solving systems of three equations with three variables. So my learning target is I will solve systems with three linear equations and three variables using substitution and Gaussian elimination, and I will formulate systems of three equations to model a real-world situation. So my definitions. The first definition we need to talk about is an ordered triple. It's an ordered pair with three values. They stand for x, y, and z. Yes, they must go in that order. Gaussian elimination. It is a long definition, but it's okay. Gaussian elimination is using the steps of elimination to eliminate the x variable from the equation 2 and 3, and then we eliminate the y value from equation 3 and solve for z, then finally using substitution to solve for x and y. You will see an example of this in a minute. So first off, let's use some substitution. This is my first equation, okay? Now, if you remember back from the last stuff of systems, when we solve for substitution, we must get one of the variables by itself. So I used my first equation here, and I solved for z. In order to solve for z, I had to subtract 2x over to the other side and subtract 7y over to the other side, which is where we get negative 53 minus 2x minus 7. So that is the first step of substitution. The second step of substitution is that now that we know what x is, we must plug it into the second equation. So I'm going to come back over here. We use these three equations always, every single time. But now that I've used the first equation to solve for x, I can no longer use the first equation. I now must use the second equation. So when I come back here, I'm going to plug z in for the second equation. So it was negative 2x plus 3y plus z, but instead of z, we're going to plug in what we found z as. We are going to simplify. Notice that there is a plus sign in front, which makes them a positive 1. We no longer need the parentheses, so we can drop them. Once we drop them, we need to combine like terms. So we have negative 2x and negative 2x, which gives me negative 4x, and 3 and negative 7y, which gives us negative 4y, minus the 53 equals 13. We add 53 to both sides to get 40, and we subtract the x over to the other side. Let me clarify. You could solve for x or for y. In this case, I chose to solve for y, but you are more than welcome to add for y over to the other side and solve for x. But we're going to solve for y just because that's what I chose in this case. So we add the 4x over to the other side. We add the 53 over to the other side to get 40. And then we divide by negative 4 to give us that y is equal to negative 10 minus x. We are two steps in. We have one more step to go before we can officially start getting what x, y, and z are. So now that I know what z is this guy right here, and y is this guy right here, I'm going to use the third equation to plug them in. So I'm going to substitute both of the solved equations into the third equation to find the final variable. Now notice, I had to take the third equation, which was 6x plus 3y, but instead of y, I used this guy, plus z, but instead of z, I used this guy. But notice there's a y right there as well, so I still had to take y and plug him in here. This is one of the main reasons why people don't choose substitution, only because this can get a little funny. But we are still going to take our time and solve. The first thing that we need to do is take this negative 7 and distribute him in, giving us positive 70 and positive 7. Then notice I scratch out my parentheses only because this guy here is a positive 1. Oh, I almost forgot. We had to distribute this 3 in as well, so that gives us negative 30 minus 3x. That's where these guys come from. That 1 right there is a positive 1, so we no longer need the parentheses. I can drop them. We combined our like terms, so I have 6 minus 3x, which just gives me 3, minus 2 more gives me 1, plus 7 gives me 8. And then we have negative 30 minus 53 plus 70 gives us negative 13. We add the 13 over to the other side, giving us negative 32, and we divide by 8, giving us x equals negative 4. Now, we are super close, but we are not completely done, because now that we know what x is, we must also know what y and z are. Now, remember, y is this negative 10 minus x, so instead of x in that spot, I'm going to plug him in. Negative 10 minus x, which is negative 4. A negative and negative makes positive, so 10 plus 4 gives us negative 6. I know what x is, I know what y is, which means when I plug it back into my z value that I can just solve for z. So we had z equals negative 53 minus 2x minus 7y. Instead of x, I put negative 4, and instead of y, I put in negative 6. Negative 2 times negative 4 gives me a positive 8. Negative 7 times a negative 6 gives me negative 42. Negative 53 plus 8 minus 42 gives us negative 3. So z equals negative 3. We write our answer as an ordered triple, negative 4, negative 6, 3, or you could write him out just like this. Now the second part is using Gaussian elimination. I took the exact same equations, and I'm going to use Gaussian elimination to solve. Now, I write them in the exact same way. Now the very first step of Gaussian elimination is that you need all of your coefficients to be the same for either x, y, or z. I always choose x. It is just a habit of mine. You are more than welcome to get rid of these z's first if you want to. I like to get rid of x first just out of habit. So in order for me to get these x's to all be the same, I would have to multiply the first and the second equation both by 3 so that I can get them to all say 6, which is exactly what I did here. So 2 times 3 gives me 6, 7 times 3 gives me 21, 3 times 1 gives me 3, and negative 53 times 3 gives me 159. Negative 2 times 3 gives me negative 6, 3 times 3 gives me 9, 1 times 3 gives me 3, and negative 13 times 3 gives me negative 39. Now, I must figure out, do I want to add the two together to give me 0 or subtract the two together to give me 0? So is it 6 plus negative 6 gives me 0 or 6 minus negative 6 gives me 0? Well, 6 minus negative 6 would give me 12, so I definitely want to add the two together. So when I add the two together, the first row stays exactly the same in the new problem because I'm not changing him. What I am changing is my second equation. So 6 plus negative 6 gives me 0. That's why that spot is blank. 21 plus 9 gives me 30. And 3 plus 3 gives me 6. We also must do the answer, which is negative 59 plus negative 39, and that gives me negative 198. Now, I'm not done because I still have the second equation to do. In my second equation, I have 6 plus 3y plus z equals negative 45. Is it 6 plus 6 gives me 0 or 6 minus 6? Again, 6 plus 6 gives me 12, so it has to be minus. 6 minus 6 gives me 0, 21 minus 3 gives me 18, 3 minus 1 gives me 2, and negative 159 minus negative 49 gives me 141, negative 149. Now, I then need to eliminate either my y or my z variable. It is easier to eliminate z because I can multiply this third equation by 3 to get both of these to match to give me 6. That's exactly what I did. And again, we must figure out, is it 6 plus 6 gives me 0 or 6 minus 6? In this case, it is 6 minus 6. So I'm going to take him. Notice my first equation and my second equation doesn't change because my first equation I'm not touching and my second equation is not the one that I'm eliminating from. It's the third. So 30 minus 54 gives me negative 24. 6 minus 6 gives me 0. And negative 198 minus 134 gives me 144. I then need to divide by negative 24 so that I can get y by itself. When I divide by itself, then we get that y is equal to negative 6. Now I can take this part. Now that I know what y is, I can plug him back in for both of those equations and simplify. When I plug him back in, I get a negative 180 plus 6z. I can add the 180 over to the other side to get 18. Then I can divide by 6. That gives me that z is equal to negative 3. I kind of jumped a step there, but that's exactly what I did. So I'm going to sit here. I plugged him in. I simplified. And I get that z is negative 3. Now that I know what y is and what z is, I can plug y in here, which I already did and I simplified, and I can plug in z there. When I plug him in, I solve. When I solve them, I get x is negative 4. So my solution is negative 4 minus 6, negative 4, negative 6, and negative 3. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to schedule a time during tutoring.